Hey there and welcome to Team GadMode's channel, where we'll be doing exclusive unbiased reviews of the latest technology in the gadget industry. And today we have with us one such device that is the latest from the Chinese telecommunications giant VIVO, which is the all new VIVO V7 Plus. The VIVO V7 Plus was launched in India last week and priced at $21,990, so that would actually make you feel that this is a mid-segment phone. However, it falls short in a couple of areas, and this phone boasts of a superior selfie quality owing to a 24-megapixel selfie shooter that is embedded in the front of it. The VIVO V7 Plus comes with a full view display that borrows its design from the Samsung Galaxy S8's Infinity Display. In terms of specifications, the VIVO smartphone is powered by an octa-core Qualcomm Snapdragon 450 SoC and carries a 4GB of RAM along with a 64GB of internal storage. So let's take a look at the build quality of the phone now. The VIVO V7 Plus has been built with an all-metal outer casing to give the phone an overall premium look. And there are two colors to choose from, the matte black and the gold, and we have with us here the gold variant. And the bottom edge has the 3.5mm audio jack and the micro USB 2.0 port, as well as the mono speaker. And the top is basically kept empty just with a noise cancellation port, thereby making the design look simple. The physical provisions are the volume rocker and the power button on one side, and the antenna has been placed quite discreetly around the top and bottom edges. The SIM card slots and the micro SD card are placed on the left hand side. So the highlight here is that the out-of-the-box square-shaped fingerprint scanner on the rear panel. We can see a VIVO branding just below the fingerprint sensor, and the bottom of the back has certain details that say that this device is manufactured by VIVO and all, etc. etc. Now moving on to the front panel, there is this massive 24-megapixel camera up front that is really good for people who want to enhance the facial features while clicking the selfies. Below this setup is the 6-inch display with very thin bezels all around, and this will attract your attention. Now switching on the phone and taking a quick look at the software, we can see here that the operating system is the Android Nougat 7.1.2 with the FunTouch operating system 3.2 riding on over it as the user interface. While the VIVO V5 was very much criticized for being an iPhone clone in terms of the phone's exterior shape and back panel design, etc. So that in the case of the V7 Plus, it is the way the icons have been designed and placed on the display screen. The FunTouch operating system here does sound like a good touch after all, and we'll tell you the reasons behind it. On paper, the Qualcomm Snapdragon 450 SoC that this phone uses might disappoint you to some extent, but it does deliver a seamless performance when it comes to multitasking and gaming. So with 4GB of RAM to support this hardware and 64GB of internal storage, the users should find the phone quite smart with the way it functions. And moving within the apps from one app to another, it will be very much smooth. The analysts are certain that this combination of the VIVO V7 Plus is able to deliver 24 to 25% better performance than the previous VIVO phones. And with a 3225mAh battery to provide the power, the users can also expect a better and longer battery life. Now taking a deeper look at the status and notification settings, you can show or hide the network speed, battery percentage, icon beautification, etc. That is just one part. Now there is this ultra smart feature called the Smart Wake. So it functions in such a way that you swipe from the bottom to top and the phone unlocks the home screen. If you do it in the opposite direction, the camera applications open up. Similarly, just the action of the letter C on the screen opens the smart dial section of the phone. So these things might sound very much fancy, but it becomes much more fancier when you have an overall control of these actions. And indeed, you can change these settings in a predefined list of settings in the Smart Wake options. You also get the Air Operations option in the settings menu, wherein you can switch on or off the black screen glance or the airlock feature. Now VIVO has bought in this fantastic feature in the V7 Plus at this time, and this is called the brand new Smart Split 3.0. So when you're running supported applications, swipe down with three fingers and the Smart Split menu is at your service. So this currently supports Facebook, WhatsApp, BBM, WeChat, play movies, etc. You also get the one-handed mode that you might have seen in any other big screen device, because that is a mandatory option to use the device with a user-friendly nature. The super screenshot feature enables the users to capture, save and play the screen activities effortlessly with just a few clicks. The super screenshot has three key features: long screenshot, funny screenshot and screen recording to make the best use of on-screen activities and save them at one go. The long screenshot makes it simple and easy for you to capture the long chat history at one go and save it, and you can also share it with your friends. The smart click feature also comes in very much handy when the screen is black and holding the volume down button opens up a window to perform a certain list of tasks. So these tasks can be actually chosen from a predefined list. Last but not the least, another interesting feature is the app clone, which helps better separate your professional life from your personal life. So this was our first part of the review of the VIVO V7 Plus. We'll be back with an in-depth review of the same phone in our second part of the video. If you like this video, then do give a thumbs up to this video, share this video, put in your valuable comments in the comment section below, subscribe to our channel, and most important of all, do not forget to press the bell icon that is just beside the subscribe button so that you stay tuned to our latest updates.